this is a night off. If you don't know it, you should. It's the best opening. So, okay, first, Alex, I played bishop e3. Just checked if I was going to play knight g4, probably. And then went for f3. So I played e6 like I played against Topalov in Riga Grand Prix. And here a4 took me by surprise because, yeah, like I said previously, I didn't remember the details of this move after b4 knight a2. I mean, there were three options in my mind. So the one I played, e5, knight b3, knight c6. There was also maybe bishop b7, but I didn't like it because of queen d2. I mean, if he takes on b4 d5, I thought this is probably playable, but after queen d2, I didn't find the move to protect this pawn. And then there's e5, knight b3, d5, but I assumed, of course, not only would he be prepared against this, but it seemed a bit shaky. I mean, probably it is the main line because it prevents bishop c4. That in the game I underestimated because after bishop e6 I missed that bishop d5 is so strong. I thought for a while, so like if I go queen c8, he takes on b4, and I think I'm just slightly worse. Queen b7, knight d3 back. If rook b8, knight a5, I didn't see equality for me here. And there was also one critical option, which is to take first on d5, play knight e7, knight takes b4, and then, well, something like a5, knight c6, because of course I cannot wait to play a5. If I go queen c7, for instance, he probably will go a5 or queen d3, and it's just not good. So a5, knight c6, I take, he takes queen c7. So I'm getting back this pawn on c6, but now the issue is I played a5, and he takes advantage of that with queen d3, queen takes c6, and queen b5. And the endgame is not great for me, so probably I should consider a move like queen d7, but it's very passive and probably just better for white. So, yeah, this is why I took so much time. And in the end, I couldn't find a completely satisfactory option because if I go bishop e7, it's the same issue, bishop d5. And it should be noted that actually, like if my bishop was not on e7, I could probably go knight b8 or knight a5. And if knight takes b4, like with the bishop on f8, that would be queen h4 check with a fork. But with the bishop on e7, this is not an option. And this was the issue that like both bishop e6 and bishop e7 make bishop d5 work. And I have really no other option. I mean, I could play rook b8, but then queen d3. It's this pawn on a6. So I went for queen c7 in the end. But I thought I'm slightly worse. So my point was always if he goes c3, knight takes bc, knight takes c3, I have knight b4. I'm hitting on the bishop on c4, and I do get some counterplay. So he went queen e2. He went castle. Now if I go bishop e6, he goes queen d3, and this is a bit unpleasant again, because well, the queen is doing very well on c4, and c3 could come next. So I went for bishop e7, now he went for c3, I take, knight takes, knight b4, queen e2. I castled, and here I think he made his first mistake. He went rook ac1. I think the other rook was more natural because he wants a5 and knight a4 at some point. So I probably have to go queen b8 because knight d5 is a serious threat. Knight takes, bishop takes. It's both rook and queen. So which is why, and if I go queen b7, this is the issue, knight a5. And if queen c7, knight d5 is very strong. If queen b8, same, knight d5, knight takes, bishop takes. This is very unpleasant. So I have to go queen b8 instead, but no a5. And knight a4 will follow next. So I wanted something like bishop d7, knight a4. And I wasn't sure whether I should take on a4, try d5. I think I probably would have settled for... no, probably not for this, because now bishop f7 and rook c8 wins. a pawn, maybe not the end of the world, but it's still a pawn. So maybe somewhere, maybe here d5, ed, knight, bd5, and I mean, this is a much better version for white than what Alexei got in the game, but it could be very holdable. I mean, I have active pieces, the pawn on a6 is a bit weak, but that counts only for the end games. There's a pair of bishop, but my knights are very active in the center. The rook is a bit awkward. I mean, not the end of the world, actually. So maybe my position is not even worse, I'm not sure. But anyway, in the game, he went rook ac1, queen b8, a5, bishop d7. And here he should have just played rook d1, for instance. Rook c8, bishop b6. I would have gone bishop d8, he goes back. And I'm not sure I can improve my position because, well, his pieces are firmly in the center. His bishop on c4 is a bit weak, but I don't have any way to take advantage of that. Rook takes c4, queen c4, bishop e6. I mean, that's why you have to go rook d1. Now you have knight d5 for white. And I mean, I don't see how I can make this work for me. It just doesn't work, so. So this is how he should have gone. Instead, he went for rook a1, so he wanted to get knight a4, but now he lost two tempi, and I'm gonna take advantage of that. In a matter of few moves. So d5 is very strong. Of course, if he takes with the bishop, knight takes, and queen takes b3 follows, so he has to take with the pawn. And now rook takes c4, which he missed, obviously. Queen takes c4, bishop b5, and there's this pin. Not exactly pin, but whatever. So anyway, his queen has to move, and this rook stays under attack, so he cannot go queen c3 because of knight takes d5. I'm winning so many tempi. So there's queen h4 and queen c1. If queen c1, bishop f1 is strong. And now the point is, if king f1, I do not take on d5 because of bishop knight b6. But first I activate my queen with queen b5 check. I take on d5. I attack this knight on b3. There's no good way to defend it. And if you go knight b6, I'll just take on b3, knight a8, knight e3. And I win material. He cannot really get back this pawn on a6. I mean, he can go knight c7, but there's gonna be an attack like e4. I'm not sure. How, but it's not gonna be good for white, that's for sure. So anyway, after bishop f1, he has to go queen f1, and now knight c2 and knight b6. Maybe it was his last chance. So, like he mentioned after the game, if knight e3, queen d3, I mean, I'm clearly much better, but there's nothing decisive yet. So, like, because my knight is under attack, this rook is under attack, my knight is trapped, I probably should take on d5 and play something like either rook a7, rook b7, or queen a7, rook b8. I mean, it's much better for me, but definitely possible to fight, at least. And of course, I should probably just take on a1 and play rook a7. And, well, the pawn on d5 is anyway doomed. So I go rook a7, then rook b7, rook c7, and queen b7, and attack this pawn, and it seems like there's some counterplay with the knight on b6, but I don't think it's enough. So because of that, in the game, it chose queen h4, but this was very wrong because he missed my next tactic. Because, of course, I can go bishop f1, I'm much better, there's no doubt about that. I can go knight f takes d5. But bishop g5 is still a fight, but bishop takes a4 ends the game immediately. The point is, after rook a4, knight d5, I attack both bishop and knight. And if he goes bishop b6 to protect the knight, this is probably what he missed. Queen takes b6, check, it's a fork, I'm winning this knight, and it's over. So after bishop a4, he tried one last trick, d6. Now if I go bishop takes d6 with the same idea, after knight d5, he has bishop c5, which now the bishop is not protected by the knight, and it's suddenly a bit unclear. But of course I had seen this, so I took on b3, takes on e7, I go knight d5. Knight c2 would leave some hope for white, for instance after bishop g5, or maybe even rook d1. But knight d5 is clinical, because after bishop c5 there's knight takes e7. And after he takes, which is what he did in the game, queen a7, check, and I'm getting this bishop back. He played for a few moves after that, but basically I just kept queens on the board and started an attack with the bishop on d5 and e4 to follow, and he just resigned.